Hello, everybody! This is Punk, Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Pokemon Fire Red playthrough. Last time, we headed south from Fuchsia City to explore Routes 19 and 20. In the process, we passed through the Seafoam Islands, an optional dungeon of sorts, where we encountered the legendary bird Pokemon Articuno, an ice-flying-type hybrid. We were able to successfully capture Articuno and add him to our Pokedex, and at the end of the last episode, we arrived at Cinnabar Island. And it is from here, at Cinnabar Island, where we will tackle the next part of the game. Now, Cinnabar Island, despite being one of the smaller areas of the game, a very self-contained city, it's home to a few notable landmarks. Obviously, we have the Pokemon Gym, but the first landmark we're going to look at is the Pokemon Lab. And as this scientist will kindly inform us, here's what they do here. We study Pokemon extensively every day. People often bring us rare Pokemon for examination. Fascinating. Now, there are a few things you can do here in the Pokemon Lab. Notably, there are actually a lot of trainers here with whom you can trade. For example, this gentleman wants a Raichu for an Electrode. I already have both of those Pokemon, so I don't need to do that. However, we can trade with this trainer. She wants a Venonat for a Tangela. And I just so happen to have a Venonat ready to go. So bring it on! We're gonna start off this episode with a little... We're gonna start off this episode with a little transaction, if you will. And there they go, showing off the GBA wireless adapter. Again, I don't have one of those. And I think they're actually rather hard to find unless you go on Amazon or something. So we have a Tangela. So that Pokemon is now added to our Pokedex. Tangela is not a Pokemon I really care for. Really, the only thing about Tangela that really stands out is the fact that in Gen 1, this was the only grass type to be pure grass type. But I've never gotten much mileage out of a Tangela. Now, if we speak to this dude, I found this most remarkable fossil inside Mount Moon. I think it's of a rare prehistoric Pokemon. You remember that fossil that I got in Mount Moon? Well, here, we can actually have the scientists here revive the fossil into a living Pokemon. And then this guy will tell us about Eevee. And this guy will actually teach us Metronome. Like other move tutors, this guy will only teach you Metronome once. Metronome was originally a TM in Gen 1. I believe it was TM35. It's no longer a TM, so you have to learn it with a move tutor in Gen 3. Hiya! I am important doctor. Yes, very much so, indeed. Here I study rare Pokemon fossils. All the time I study. You, have you a fossil for me? Why, yes, I have two, so now we can finally revive these two fossils and actually get living Pokemon. So the dome fossil is the fossil of Kabuto. So let's turn on the resurrection machine. Handed the dome fossil to the weird doctor. I take a little time, you go for a walk a little while. I don't even know what kind of voice I was trying to give that guy. So this little trainer down here is looking for a Ponyta, and if we trade him a Ponyta, we'll get a seal. Unfortunately, I don't have Ponyta, and we're in Fire Red and Leaf Green, you're actually not going to see Ponyta for quite a while. Ponyta was originally found on Cycling Road in Gen 1, but they moved some of the Pokemon around for Gen 3. Now, basically, when you give a fossil to the weird doctor, you won't get the Pokemon right away. You have to leave the lab and then come back. But I think that's all you have to do. You just have to step outside and then step back in. You late! Where were you? Your fossil is back to life. It was Kabuto, like I think. So we get Kabuto, and we can give this dude a nickname. Let's see here. Alright, so we have Kabuto, one of the fossil Pokemon. I ultimately did not give him a nickname because as soon as I was going to give him a nickname, my mind went blank. So Kabuto does not have a nickname as of yet, but we can also give the Old Amber to the Weird Doctor. Old Amber is a fossil that we obtained in Pewter City, and it is the fossil of Aerodactyl. And once again, it's time to go for a little walk. Alright, so here we are back in the lab, and of course we did receive Aerodactyl, and I know what nickname I'm gonna give this bad boy. It's time for another kaiju reference, ladies and gentlemen. So let's actually take a look at these two fossil Pokemon that I managed to obtain. Although the first thing I want to do, first I want to go ahead and deposit Tangela here. I'm probably never ever going to use it, but it's good to have it for the sake of fulfilling that entry in the Pokedex. Okay, let's take a look at Kabuto. Kabuto is a rock and water hybrid, and it evolves into Kabutops at, I believe, level 40. So if you want this thing to level up and hopefully get some mileage out of it, be prepared to do some work. But it does have a good ability here, Battle Armor, which blocks critical hits. I can certainly get behind that. And let's go ahead and take a look at Aerodactyl, a level 5 Aerodactyl, a rock and flying hybrid. Only knows Wing Attack at the moment. And its ability is Rock Head, which prevents recoil damage, which I'm sure can be certainly useful. And as for the other fossil Pokemon, is Omanyte, who is revived from the Helix fossil. Unfortunately, if I want Omanyte, I'm going to have to trade from my Leaf Green version, because you can only get, because again, when you get the fossil from Mount Moon, you can only pick one of the two. And unfortunately, you can't trade items, so you know, you have to revive the Pokemon in the other version and then trade it over, which is annoying, but that's the way it works. That's how it worked in Gen 1 anyway, and that is the frame of reference I'm going to be going with for the most part. Because like I've said before, I was there from the beginning when Pokemon first showed up. Like, when Pokemon first hit the States, I was like 7-8 years old. So, obviously Gen 1 is the generation that I'm most familiar with, and it definitely influences my views on Pokemon. But now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the meat of this episode. It's time for the Pokemon Mansion, an abandoned mansion slash laboratory of sorts. And we have our first encounter with a wild Pokemon. It's going to be Koffing, a poison Pokemon, which I would actually like to capture. So let's see if we can actually do that. Never mind. It decided, nope, I'm going to blow up. Yeah, that's what you want to be careful of with Pokemon like Koffing and its evolved form Weezing. It basically functions a lot like Electrode and Voltorb. It'll blow itself up if it's at a disadvantage. Luckily, I have some potions to heal the damage. Anyway, I do believe there's a hidden item around the entrance. Might want to try grabbing that. But we've also got Raticate here. Let's see if I can get away. I may just have to go ahead and use a Repel here so that I'm not getting bogged down in Pokemon battles. Although, obviously, repels will not do the trick against actual rival trainers, but that's just something we gotta deal with. Okay, let's actually go through here. Now, unlike some previous areas, unlike the Power Plant and Seafoam Islands, this area is not optional. You have to go through this area to get a very specific item, and the item you obtain from here is what you need in order to enter the gym. We cannot enter the gym here on Cinnabar Island at first because we need a key. And obviously, of course, we're going to have to track that down. But we are going to come across our first trainer of the video, and it's going to be a youngster. What the hell are you doing in a place like this, kid? Then again, what the hell am I doing here? You know, my character's a kid too. Leading off with Ekans against Seath, my Dragonair. Once again, my Dragonair's nickname is a reference to Seath the Scaleless from Dark Souls. Alright, did not get the poison status, so this Dragon Rage should do the trick. So anyway, when you're going through the Pokémon Mansion, mostly you're going to be encountering fire types and poison types, in addition to normal types like Raticate. And of course Rattata, but you're also going to be encountering Koffing, Weezing, Muk, Grimer, and... Well, I remember encountering fire types like Growlithe. You know, depending on what version you play, you might encounter Growlithe as well as Vulpix. And there was a Pokemon here that was exclusive to Blue version, but much like Ponyta, its location has been changed. We'll worry about that in a moment, because now it's time to deal with a Raticate. I'll bring out China, my newly evolved Machamp. And yeah, this Raticate is going to get the speed advantage on me. Luckily, Pursuit isn't going to do very much, but this Karate Chop ought to do a good number. Critical hit, super effective. You know what that means. One hit KO. Alright, so now it's on to sort of the main gimmick of the Pokemon Mansion. We have these odd-looking statues that contain switches. Activate a switch and certain doors in the mansion will open. These doorways will open up new pathways, and you will also be able to grab certain items that otherwise you may not be able to grab unless you manipulate the switches. We're going to have to do this mechanic throughout the mansion in order to not only get all the items, but also to get out in the first place. And here we are with, I believe this is probably going to be a, not a scientist, but a burglar. Yes. And yep, these guys usually bring along fire types, much like I remember them doing so in Gen 1. So we are dealing with a Charmander here. Scary face, that's going to knock down my speed. My speed harshly fell! It didn't just fall, it harshly fell. The game wants us to know that. And dropping my accuracy, but luckily not enough to prevent this Thunderbolt from delivering the knockout blow, and down goes Charmander. But he's not done with us yet. Now he's going to bring out a Charmeleon. Alright, the evolved form of Charmander. We have yet to actually encounter a Charizard, however, and I don't think we're going to. At least, not anytime soon. So let's see, alright, Charmeleon gets the jump on me with Metal Claw. Not a very impressive hit, but here's the follow-up. And Shenron, my Gyarados, delivers the knockout hit. That's right, I've swapped out my water Pokemon once again. Now I'm rolling with Gyarados, who is also one of my favorite water types. And I want to say... Okay, so these balcony type areas are actually important, because there's actually an area where we need to literally jump off a balcony to get to a lower level. But also we have diaries scattered throughout the mansion, which are basically logs from an experiment. July 10th, we christened the newly discovered Pokemon, Mew. Interesting. You don't really get anything for reading all these diaries, but they do offer some background as to what occurred here at the Pokemon Mansion. July 5th, Guiana, South America. A new Pokemon was discovered deep in the jungle. Alright, so we read those out of order, but you get the idea. And we get a Calcium, another stat-boosting item. But I think, once again, we're going to have to manipulate the Switches. And I don't mean the Nintendo Switch, as much as I would love to own one. Seriously, if I had the money, I would seriously get a Switch right now. I want to get a Switch. Especially so I can play Super Mario Odyssey. That game looks like it's really fun. But anyway, we need to stay on subject here. Our journey through the mansion continues. And once again, more Switch manipulation. No, I don't want to press it because I just did it. Let's not button mash here. All right, it's from this area where you need to jump off. However, we need to deal with another trainer. And this time, we're actually going to fight a scientist, and he's going to come at us with a Magnemite. Okie dokie then. Yes, returning to the lineup is Skull, my Marowak. You may remember Skull from the Fuchsia City Gym episode, where Skull was quite the contributor to ultimately beating that gym. He's back for his return tour, if you will. And he gives us a nice knockout with Bone Club, although he did miss the first time around, which is annoying. At least he landed the hit when it counted, and this guy's going straight for the big guns with a Magneton, and wow, I actually outsped a Magneton. I don't even have Skull equipped with the Quick Claw, and I actually outsped that Magneton. Who knows what it was trying to do? And out comes Voltorb. I don't think I'm going to outspeed this thing. Voltorb and Electrode are among the fastest Pokemon, so... One hit point! That's your big move to deal 1 HP of damage. Get out of here! Okie dokie then. Arr! A pirate doesn't say okie dokie then. A pirate says arr. Anyway, come down here and you can get an HP up. Right. But I don't think we're quite done just yet. I think it's time for a little more Switch manipulation. We will head this way. Wait a minute, I think I already went through here. Even I'm getting lost. That one dude, that burglar talked about getting lost. Now I'm getting lost. There is one area, though, that I want to go through, which involves going up this flight of stairs right here, because I think we're going to have another burglar to deal with, which means I think this is a job for Shenron. This place is, like, huge! Yeah, I've gathered that. Alright, this guy has only one Pokemon, but it's a big one. It's a level 38 Ninetales. We might have our work cut out for us here. He's got the level advantage, but I have the type advantage. Let's see who wins. Well, he's also going to get the first hit with Quick Attack. But can you survive the retaliation? And give it credit, it actually... Well, I think it's because it had the level advantage that I didn't do all that much with Surf, but the second hit should do it in, and yes, it will. A for effort, thanks for playing. Ooh, and a nice payday for beating that guy. February 6th, Mew gave birth. We named the newborn Mewtwo. Right in front of the item! Hello! Nice to meet you, level 32 Weezing. Let's go to work. For the love of God, do not blow up. Ah! I knew it. Didn't kill me, surprisingly. What was the point of that? I think that Weezing got into a battle with me just so it could blow up in my face. I might have a hard time trying to catch Koffing and Weezing if they're just gonna blow up as soon as I lay one hit on them. Wait a moment. No? Okay. I thought I saw another pathway, and I was thinking, wait a second. We already went that way. Okay, I think the first thing I need to do is... Is this pathway up here clear? Yes, it is. I think it's finally time to actually go ahead and just, drop off to the lower level. I don't think we're really gonna get anything else done. I'm just gonna run away from these battles. I'm not gonna worry about catching anything until maybe after I record the episode. I mean, I'm already at the 22-minute mark, almost, in recording, so let's not take too long here. Okay, repel is already in effect. Oh wait, I think I know why I'm getting jumped. I think it's because those Weezing were at a higher level than Shenron. That's what was going on. Aiee! My back! I don't think I landed where I thought I was gonna land. I think it's like where you step off determines where you land, and I don't think I landed where I wanted to land. And I'm gonna have to manipulate the switches again. So anyway, like I was gonna say, yes, my Gyarados' nickname is a Dragon Ball Z reference. So I have two Pokemon named after dragons. I have my Dragonair named after Seath, and I have my Gyarados named after Shenron. And Dark Souls and Dragon Ball Z are two very different things to be referencing. Let's see, do I fight that trainer? Why not? I mean, really, it's not like I'm not gonna visit this area ever again, because again, there are wild Pokemon here that I want to catch. But I don't want to bog down the video trying to catch those Pokemon when we actually have something that we actually need to do here. You know what I'm saying? Starting off with Sonic Boom! You're not Guile! Get out of here, Electrode. This isn't Street Fighter! Alright. Gonna come out with the Weezing, are ya? I'd keep Skull in, but in Gen 3, Koffing and Weezing got the ability Levitate, which cancels out the effects of ground-type attacks. So Skull wouldn't actually be that useful in this situation, but Mind Bender certainly will be useful. You might be able to negate ground attacks, but it won't do you any good against Psychic. And China wants to learn a move. Let's see. Vital Throw. It could be useful in a given situation, I'm sure. A retaliatory attack that doesn't miss. I can live with that. I can do something with that. By the way, China is a reference to the former professional wrestler who passed away in 2016. Rest in peace. Because I am a wrestling fan. Anyway, it's from here where we are in the basement of the Pokemon Mansion, and once again, we're gonna have to press some more switches in order to get the item that we need. But first, another journal. September 1st. Mewtwo is far too powerful. We have failed to curb its vicious tendencies. Sounds dire. Alright, so let's go ahead and activate that switch, or rather deactivate it, because the light's turned off. And I might be running out of max repels here, but I did stock them up for areas like this. And a full restore, and living up to that name, a full restore will not only heal HP, it will also get rid of any status affliction. So if you can have a nice supply of full restore, you'll be all set. This place is ideal for a lab. Look at all this space. Yeah, I think going by those journal entries, somebody tried the lab thing once before and it didn't work out very well. Just saying. Alright, so let's go ahead and take out this Magnemite. Bone Club, double weakness equals death. Or knockout, again. And let's see. Ooh, bring out the Electrode. Okay. Roll out. 1 HP. Get out of here. Oh, you want to take both hits from it, do ya? Okay, I see how it is. I see how it is, Electrode. Thank you, sir. May I have another? That's what that Electrode was saying right there. He took the first hit from Boomerang and was like, bitch, I ain't going nowhere. Hit me again. TM14 contains Blizzard, a powerful ice-type move. Alright. I might be teaching that to one of my Pokémon somewhere down the line. Activate another switch, and this should give us what we need. Secret key! There it is! But I think if we go down here... TM22 contains Solar Beam, a powerful grass-type move. I think we may have actually... Well, first we've locked ourselves in. Need to rectify that. So let's... I think this might be the last time that we need to manipulate the switches. Alright, so after a wild Raticate decided to rudely interrupt me, I think all we have to do is maybe manipulate the statues one last time, and we should be able to get out of this place. I'm gonna go ahead and put Falco up front. He's my highest level Pokemon. I don't think any wild Pokemon in here is higher than level 44, so we should be okay. But before we leave, I think we might want to take care of this last trainer right over here. So, I'm assuming he's a burglar. Uh-oh, where am I now? You're in trouble, that's where you are. Alright, a Growlithe going up against Shenron here, okay. Oh wow, we both intimidate each other. Huh. So basically, we just leveled the playing field. Basically, we reset our stats. I lowered his attack and then he lowered mine. So it was like we canceled each other out. What was that all about? All right, here we are. We are actually gonna get to see a Ponyta. Once again, in Gen 3 compared to Gen 1, this Pokémon's location has been moved around, but we will be able to capture one eventually. Now, in this area in Gen 1, there was a Pokémon exclusive to Blue version, a Fire-type Pokémon named Magmar, but much like Ponyta, Magmar has also been moved to a different location, and in Gen 3, Magmar is exclusive to Leaf Green. So that's another Pokémon I'm gonna have to trade for somewhere down the line. Whew! We finally got out of that gauntlet, ladies and gentlemen, and using that secret key that we obtained, we can actually enter the gym. However, we're not going to tackle the gym in this video. We're going to head back to the Pokemon Center and we're going to heal up. Because ladies and gentlemen, I think we've done just about everything I intended to show off in this episode. So let's go ahead and heal. And ladies and gentlemen, that is going to conclude this episode of the Pokemon Fire Red playthrough. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now. I hope to see all of you in the next episode.